I'm Dr. Charley. I'm so glad to see you for your appointment this evening. How are you doing? Okay, good. Well, you can just sit back and relax, and I'll take very good care of you at your checkup, and let's get you all registered, okay? To start off with, what is your first name? Great. And your last name? Okay. Date of birth? And are there any specific concerns that you would like to cover with me this evening? Absolutely. We can check that out for you and make sure everything is just fine. Okay, wonderful. To get started, I'm going to listen to your heart and to your lungs to make sure that everything sounds clear and healthy and to get your pulse too. Side. Very good. Now around back. Okay, and take a deep breath for me. One more deep breath. Wonderful. Everything sounds very good and clear. All right. Next, we are going to do a quick temperature check under your tongue to make sure that you don't have a fever. Okay. So, open up your mouth for me. Okay, this is just going to go right under your tongue. Okay, 98.2, so that's perfect. All right, let me just write down. The information here, so ...98.2, no fever. Heart and lungs sounded very clear. And pulse of 72 beats per minute. To take your blood pressure. This won't hurt at all. It'll just be a little bit of pressure around your left arm. And this will make sure that your blood pressure isn't too high and that we're right on track. So if you can just give me your arm. Put this, get it kind of wrapped around here. Relax. Okay. discomfort at all. And your blood pressure was 118 over 78. Which is really good, it's perfectly normal. Okay, great. Now for the rest of the examination, I am going to put on my glove. Now, I'm going to look in your throat, in your nose, look at your eyes, and in your ears. Make sure everything looks good. Alright, to start off with, let's have this little light, and go ahead and open your mouth for me. And say ah. Okay, we'll do that once more, okay? Alright, open your mouth. This is just going to go in a little bit so I can depress your tongue and get a really good and clear look at the back of your throat. Great. Your throat looks very good. Now I'm going to actually just look up your nostrils just to make sure that there's no blockages. So go ahead and just lift your chin up just a little bit so I can see under a little bit. Okay. Looks really good. I'm going to look in each eye just to make sure that everything looks good and clear. I'm going to start with this eye right here, and if you could look up a little bit up into the corner, that would be helpful so I can get a good look at the iris of your eye. Okay, so look up. I'm just going to take my hand and gently pull down on your lower lid. Look straight at me now, but I am still going to look at this eye over here. So I'm going to open it just a little bit. Okay. Great. Now we're going to look at this eye. So I'm going to pull down just a little bit on your lower lid, and again, you look up to this corner, and we'll take a corner. Good. Your nose looks very good. You do have a little bit of dryness in your eyes, so I think what we'll do is just put a couple of eye drops so they can feel a little bit moisturized, and it will be much more comfortable for you. Sometimes when our eyes are dry, it causes us to blink more and have a little bit of a sandy sensation, and that can just kind of cause some irritation and sensitivity. So this should be very comfortable for you. Just open this. Okay. And we'll start with this eye. I'm going to have you again look up this way so I can get your eye drop in. Okay, I'll pull up on the upper lid here, and here we go. And now we'll do the other eye. So look up this way. Get you over here. Okay. Blink your eyes a little bit for me. Do an overall skin assessment and skin check on your face to see if we find any abnormal dark spots from the sun. I know it's easy to forget sunscreen and things like that, so we'll just check around your skin, make sure everything looks good, and see if you have any other skin conditions, okay? So first I'm just going to wipe off your skin so it's nice and clean. This cotton ball down your nose first. Okay, if you can actually just lift your chin up a little bit for me. Think your skin is nice and cleaned off. So first I am just going to be touching and feeling around your face a little bit to see if I can feel any, you know, abnormalities in your skin. Okay, let me get by your ears a little bit. Okay, let me look at your forehead. Okay, the condition of your skin looks very good. I don't see any abnormalities. I do see a slight bit of eczema on the sides of your nose right here and right here. Okay. You can use a cream on this that will help to calm and soothe it and hopefully take some of that eczema away. Okay, now we are going to check your sinuses to make sure that there's nothing in there and they don't feel painful or anything like that. So I'm just going to gently tap on your sinus cavities and tell me if you feel any kind of pain. It will be very gentle, okay? So we'll start right here. Any pain right here? Okay, good. Now we'll do up here on your forehead. Okay, did you feel any discomfort? Okay, great. voices are doing very well. If you ever do have any congestion or anything like that, which many people do, especially this time of year, you can do a little bit of massaging on your sinuses. You know, just a little bit of massaging to try to help relieve some of that pressure. Okay, wonderful. Okay, great. Now, I would like to just do a quick cleaning of your ears, the outside of your ears, to make sure that everything is really clean and nice, and that you don't have any blockages so you can hear properly and clearly. So, I'm just going to come over here to this ear first. Okay. And I'm going to pull this earlobe back just a little bit. One looks pretty clean. Good. Now let's do the other one. So we're just going to pull this earlobe back just very gently, just a little bit. And we'll go ahead and clean this one. Very good. I did not see any blockages, so I think you've been keeping your ears very clean, and that is wonderful. Alright, so now I would like to do a very quick vision test, just of the peripheral side of your vision, to make sure that you're not having any blind spots or anything like that that aren't supposed to be there. So, if you can, I'm going to actually cover one part of your eye with this, or one eye with this. We're going to start with this eye, and I want you to look at my fingers and tell me how many fingers I am holding up, okay? So, we'll cover this eye right here. Okay. All right, great. Tell me how many fingers I'm holding up. One. Four. Good. Three, that's right. One. Five. Three. Very good, you got them all right. Now let's go ahead and check your other eye. So I will be covering up this eye. And it's just the same thing. Make sure that you are looking straight at me. Don't look at my hands, just use your peripheral vision to tell me how many fingers I'm holding up. Okay, let's get started. Two, good. Four, good. Five, very good. Three, good. Four. Make a note. Your peripheral vision seems to be very well intact and no issues whatsoever. Okay, great. Now I'm going to just feel along your neckline. Make sure that you don't have any swollen lymph nodes or any discomfort or anything. check your glands and your nose primarily. Okay. So you can just look straight at me, lift your chin up just a little bit. Did you feel any discomfort? Okay. Good. Seems like everything's going quite well then. Alright. Okay. Now, I did notice just right under your neck here, you do just have a little bit of a scratch. So I'm going to go ahead and clean that off for you and put a little bandage on it. Shouldn't take no time really to heal at all. So, let's go ahead. Clean this off. Just make sure that we get it disinfected properly. So if you can just look up this way for me just a little bit. On there for you. Perfect. Alright. Now, to treat the eczema that I was talking about earlier, right here on the sides of your nose, I do have a cream that we can put on it to hopefully soothe some of that sensitivity, reduce some of the inflammation, and take away any itchiness and flakiness of your skin to hopefully make it a little bit more comfortable for you. So, I'm actually going to put this on just like this. And we will just dab it very gently on the sides of your nose here. Okay. And the other side. Just rub it in just a little bit. Okay, great. All right, now we are going to going to just take just a little bit of a sample, a blood sample from your arm, and to send it to the lab for a test, just to make sure that we have your correct blood type and that all of your levels are correct as well. We'll be taking a look at your cholesterol, blood sugar level, and things like that. Okay. It won't hurt at all. You can just, I'm going to roll up your sleeve here. Around a little tight up here. Okay. And disinfect. And you shouldn't even feel a thing. If you would like to look away, you certainly can. Okay, it's all disinfected. And a little bandage on it. Okay, wonderful. So we should have those results for you in probably about a week or so. They will be uploaded to your patient portal, so you can check that out, and always feel free to give me a call with any questions. Do you have any questions for me right now? No, I don't think you have anything to worry about. Everything really looks very good. So let's just make a note. Your next follow-up appointment should be in 6 months. And if you have any concerns in the meantime, can absolutely give our office a call, and we'll be happy to assist you. If there are any issues with your blood work, of course we'll give you a call. I don't anticipate that happening whatsoever. Just make a note about the blood work, and that we did disinfect and bandage the little scratch. Good. How do your eyes feel since we put in the eye drops? Okay. You still feel a little bit itchy, yeah. You will probably want to get some of the eye drops at your local drugstore, and probably you can use them, you know, as frequently as needed to help the discomfort. Let me look at your eyelids real quick. If you could close your eyes for me. Make sure there's nothing, no irritation on there. Make sure you close your eyes. You know, I do see just a little bit of eczema on your eyelid, which is causing a little bit of your skin to flake. That could be causing a little bit of irritation, so I am going to wipe that off. So go ahead and close your eyes for me again. I'm just going to use this cotton ball to try to just wipe off the eye area, and then we can apply a very light cream that's safe for your eyes. Okay, so I'm going to get started with this eye. Okay, go ahead and close your eyes. Overall, it looks fairly good. I am going to just apply a little bit of this cream. Okay, close your eyes again for me. Just dab it very gently right on your eyelid. See if we can soothe and calm some of this dryness. Okay, other eyelid. Okay, it's really not too bad. Just a little bit. I'll send you home with some of this cream so you can apply it yourself as needed. Closed. I'm just gonna look. Okay, it looks okay. I think that should help soothe your eyes along with the eye drops. Follow up with me in about a week if it's causing you any discomfort or if it doesn't feel like it's progressing in the correct direction. All right, any last questions for me? Okay, wonderful. It was so nice to see you. And I do hope you come back and see me again for your follow-up appointment.